In the last class, we discussed the state of pi. So, what is the state of pi? He was very much tired due to his weakness. He did not eat food or did not drink water. So, he was in search of water. Okay, that is the state of pi we saw in the last class. And what about the Richard Parker? That is what we are going to discuss in this. Richard Parker still on board. Richard Parker is still on the boat. Where is he? He directly beneath me. So, he is beneath. Beneath means under me. Okay. Incredible. Incredible means unbelievable. It is unbelievable that a thing need consent true after deliberation. What is the incredible here? He did not believe that a very big Bengal tiger is below me. And he thought that it is a deliberation. Okay, and delusion, assessing various mental items. What deliberation means? Forcefully making you to think. Now, what happened? He was searching for a drink. He did not find anything. Okay, now he is forced to see Richard Parker. Now only he came to know that there is tiger beneath me and there were various mental items. He concluded, what are the various mental items? Dream, delusion, misplaced memory and fancy. He thought that it is not a dream. What is not dream? When he saw Richard Parker, and actually he did not notice about that since he was so weak, okay, he did not think that it is not a dream or delusion, okay, not fact image or misplaced memory. What is misplaced memory? That is a memory which is misplaced in your memory, that there is a tiger beneath you. It is not misplaced. Okay. It is rightly known that there is Richard Parker below you. And it is not fancy. What do you mean by fancy? Beyond our thinking. Okay. Imagination. So, Richard Parker is there below me and it is not fancy, he says. It is not a dream. It is not delusion. And it is not misplaced memory or fancy. And he says it is not falsity. Falsity means false. So, it is not false that Richard Parker is not here. Okay. So, what is the truth? The truth is Richard Parker is beneath me. And he says solid true thing. Okay. It is solid. Okay. What is the true thing? Witness that Richard Parker is below me. While in weakened. So, what is weakened? Weakened means I am tired. Since I did not have a drink or did not have a food, I am weak. But the solid truth is Richard Parker is below me. Highly agitated state. What is highly agitated state? That means very much angry. Okay. Highly agitated. Who is agitated? Pi is agitated. Since he did not eat or drink, he is so weak. The truth of it would confirm, felt enough to investigate. The truth itself is enough. That, what is investigation? That Richard Parker is there below me. Because last 2.5 days, he did not notice Richard Parker. He did not mind about Richard Parker. Now only he saw the Richard Parker and he was analyzing about Richard Parker. Okay. Failed to notice 2.5 days. A 450-pound Bengal tiger. So, what is the weight of the tiger? The weight of the tiger is 450-pound. Okay. So, this big size animal was there on the board and Pi did not notice for how many days? 2.5 days he did not notice. 26 feet long. What is the length of the Bengal tiger? 26 feet he says. Okay. A conundrum. Conundrum means a riddle. Okay, in Tamil we say vidugadai. Okay, it is unsolved answer. Okay, a riddle. Who is here? A conundrum. Conundrum means riddle. So, what is riddle here? Richard Parker is a riddle. What is a riddle? Solve later when I had more energy. Feet made Richard Parker. What he says? This big size 450-pound Bengal tiger was beneath me and it is very big. Conundrum, very big riddle for me to solve. What is the riddle here? That this big Bengal tiger was beneath me and he says the latest to stow away. What do you mean by stow away? A person, one who hides okay, in the ship, okay, very big person. So the Richard Parker was there instead of a person, okay. That is what he says. From tip of nose to tip of tail took over a third of the length of the ship, okay. He has taken the space of a third of the length of the ship, he says, which means the larger part of the ship is occupied by Bengal tiger, he says. So what is the riddle here? The riddle is this 450-pound Bengal tiger was there on the boat, and it is wonder how it is not noticed by me, and it occupied a third of the length of the ship. Then how it is possible, he says, I will solve it when I had more energy. Now I have no energy, I am so weakened by not drinking water or not eating food. I have no energy to solve this problem. I will solve this problem later when I have more energy, he says. Okay. So next what happened? You think, you may be wonder. So he says to the narrator, what? I lost hope. Okay. Who lost hope? Pi lost hope. I purged up, felt much better, he says. What do you mean by purged? Purged means straightened or erect. Sit erect. Okay. So he made his body to sit erect. Felt much better now. Okay. Anyhow, he lost hope. Why he lost hope? Because he has seen a 450-pound Bengal tiger which is ready to eat him. So that's why he lost hope. So he thought that anyway I am going to die, then why should I worry? So he took his body, okay, straightened his body and felt much better. We see sports all the time. Now he is giving an example. What is the example? Okay, how a weakened person mind is. So for that he gives one example. What is that? Sports all the time. Okay. When in the sports, he takes one particular sport, tennis, okay. A tennis challenger, when he starts his play, he is very strong in the beginning. So when he starts the game, he is very strong and he wants to win the game. But what happens? Soon he loses. So he starts losing his points. So when he loses his points, his confidence goes down. Confidence in his playing. What happened? When he loses points, his confidence goes down. So the champion racks up the games. So what happened? He is in the end of the defeat. Racks means defeat. So the champion is in the end of the game. The final set has come. So at this particular time, the challenger nothing left to lose. So what happened? It is already decided that he is going to lose the game. It is no use to try again. So he is in such kind of situation. So what happens? He becomes relaxed. Okay, you understand? So he becomes relaxed means anyhow I am going to lose. Why should I try harder? So anyhow I am going to lose. So I am going to be relaxed, he says. So in sufficient, what do you mean by sufficient? Sufficient means carefree. Being very free. Why should I worry? So that's what he says. Insouciant means I am free. So already I have lost. Daring. Okay. So what he says, in the game, the champion is in the end of the game. He is going to be defeated soon. So he loses his confidence and he is relaxed and carefree. Insouciant means carefree. Then what happens? Suddenly he is playing like a devil. So what happens? Suddenly the particular champion, one who is going to be defeated, starts playing like a devil. How? He plays very fast. He beats very fast. The champion work hard, get those lost points. So the champion, one who is going to be defeated in the final set, tries very hard to get the lost points. So it with me. So it is very, very important here only. Why is giving this example of tennis player? So it is with me also, he says. Let's make a comparison. Okay. Richard Parker is another tennis player and Pi is another tennis player. So Pi is very weakened. He lost many points. He is in the final set. Richard Parker is going to win. okay, the other opponent. Now what happened? Richard, the pi is going to defeated and he is the end of the life. He knows that anyhow I am going to lose. So now you have a comparison. The Richard Parker is going to be the winner. Pi is going to be the loser. As we saw in the tennis, the champion, one who is going to lose. Here the pi is going to lose his life. Then what he says, anyhow I am going to die, then why should I worry? In the same way the tennis player feels that I am going to lose, why should I worry? Let me try, he says. So that is why he says, so it is with me, he says. Now there is another animal, cope up with the aina. So his aina is like a dog, like an African animal. Okay, it looks like a almost dog. So I have to deal with this aina also, which is remotely possible, which is so far, far away from me, I have to deal with also. I obviously outmatched by Richard Parker. What do you mean by outmatched? Better than me, he says. So Richard Parker is the winner. It is obviously clear. What do you mean by obviously means? It is very clear. Richard Parker is the winner. Outmatched me means he defeated me. It is very clear. Not worth worrying about it. It is not worth to worry about the defeat, because anyhow Richard Parker is the winner and I am the loser and I am going to lose my life. So why should I worry about that, he says. Tiger aboard. So now the tiger is, what do you mean by aboard? Aboard means on the boat, on the ship, okay, on the lifeboat. The tiger is on the lifeboat. My life over, he says. So what he says, anyhow as the champion feels that he is going to be defeated in the end, okay, in the same way pi also feels that his life is going to be the end. So Richard Parker is going to be the winner. My life is over. I am not going to live. Okay, then why should I worry, he says. In the final, finally he says, why not do something? My parched throat. What do you mean by parched? Parched means dry. Okay, why the throat is dry? Because he did not have a drink. He wants to drink water. So what he says, let us not worry about Richard Parker. Anyhow, I am going to die. Let us do something about the water. Let me drink water and wet my parched throat, he says. So now, Pi is not worried about Richard Parker. Now he knows that he is going to be killed by Richard Parker, that is Bengal tiger. Now he is worried about the water. Now he knows that he is going to be killed and he needs water. So now let's see how he is going to get water. Now we know that there is a hyena and there is a Richard Parker, okay, like the pi. Okay, now pi is worried about water, not of Richard Parker. The reason is he is above, the Richard Parker is above him because he has no strength to escape from him. Now he wants water, anyhow he knows that he is going to be killed because he has given the example of the tennis player, okay, one who lost his match and he lost his confidence level. He knows that he is going to be defeated, but anyhow he wants to live. So in that same way, now Richard Parker is going to kill Pi and he knows that, Richard Parker knows that he is going to be killed. Anyhow he wants to live. That's why he is in search of water. Let us see how he finds water. So I believe that saved my life. What saved my life? He believes that. That saved my life. What saved his life? That urge of living. He knows that Richard Parker is going to kill him. Okay. So that thought, okay, anyhow I am going to be killed by Richard Parker, but I need water. That particular thought saved him, he says. So that morning, literally what happened? Dying of thirst. So that morning it was dying of thirst. Thirst means what? The need of water. So he is very much thirst to drink water. That particular word, what word? The thirst. This thirst word
popped into my mind. What do you mean by popped? Burst or hit in mind. What word? Thirst. This particular thirst was hitting his mind always, not thinking anything else. Okay. So he needs water. He feels that he is thirsty and he needs water. That particular word hitting him in his head. And he did not think of anything else. The word itself, only the word he thinks. Salty the more thought of it. Now what happened? That particular thought, okay, made him not to think anything, it made him not to think anything else but the water. But what happened? The word itself became salty. Salty means what? The salt water we cannot drink, we cannot eat more salty food, isn't it? So what happened? It became very salty, the word itself, because he was always thinking about water and the thirst. Okay? So the more thought of it, the worse of effect. So the more he was thinking of the thirst and water, his health and his mind became very worse. And he gives an example. What? He heard. What he heard? The hunger exists. Compelling sensation of the thirst of water. A few minutes you die and discomfort of asphyxiation. What do you mean by asphyxiation? Dying of lack of oxygen. Okay? Dying of suffocation. That is called asphyxiation. Okay? Death due to lack of oxygen is called asphyxiation. Now, what he heard at the particular point, he remembers that a person, one who is of thirst of water, one who did not drink water for a long time, that particular person will die of discomfort. He will have a discomfort of breathing air, that is oxygen, okay, goes away. Okay, the particular person dies and gets discomforted and feels the person one who feels thirsty will die of asphyxiation, he says. This particular thing goes away, drawn out. What goes out? What goes away? This discomfort. Okay. When the person is very thirsty, okay, very discomfort, that particular thing goes away when he dies. Because after death, he is not going to suffer. That's why he says, goes away, drawn out. Now he gives another example of Christ. Who is Christ here? Jesus Christ. Christ on the cross died of suffocation. If you have seen the movie, The Passion of Christ, you might know how Jesus was crucified. So he was nailed on the cross. Okay, he was uplifted. Okay, he was so much he had a thirst. Nobody was there to give him water. So Christ on the cross died of suffocation. So Christ, Jesus Christ died of suffocation. That is a lack of oxygen, because oxygen was around him, but he could not breathe the oxygen because his throat was so parched. Parched means so dry. Okay. So that's the reason he died. His only complaint, thirst. Whose complaint? Jesus Christ complained. If you have seen that particular movie, in the last scene, he says to his father, he says to God, God, I am thirsty. Why did you leave me? He says. Okay? So he asked God, why did you leave me? With the thirst, he asks. So God incarnate complains. You see, he gives an example. Even God complains about a thirst of water. Why not me? He says. As a human, God himself complained that there is no water and I am thirsty, God says. And mere human being, imagine on an ordinary human being like me. What happens to me? God himself is thirsty and he did not have water to drink and he died. And what about me? An ordinary man can do, he says. It enough make me raving mad. He says that particular point is enough for me to get mad, he says. What do you mean by ravingly? Ravingly means wildly, behaving wildly. He says, God himself did not have water to drink. He had thirst. And what about me, like a ordinary human being? I am very mad, and he was shouting. I never known physical hell than putrid taste and pasty feeling in the mouth. He says, since I did not drink water for a long time, it was physical hell for me, he says. Physical hell than putrid taste. Okay. What in the putrid taste? Putrid means rotting. Rotting means what? A fruit rots, isn't it? So, decompose, we say. When a person did not drink water for a long time, his mouth will become so dry and you will have a putrid taste. Very rotten food or fruit taste. And what do you mean by pasty feeling? Pasty means when you did not drink water, all the salivas will become like a paste, okay, in the mouth. What he says, physical hell than putrid taste. This particular putrid taste and pasty is more than this physical pain, he says. So, the pain is very worse is this. Okay, what is the worse? Worse than putrid taste and pasty feeling, he says, in the mouth. Next he says, unbearable pressure at the back of throat. Since I did not drink for a long time, there is a pressure at my back of throat, he says. That pressure is unbearable, cannot be borne by a person, he says. So, sensation, what sensation? This sensation, unbearable pressure, this particular sensation makes my blood turning to thick syrup, he says. So, when there is a very sore taste and pressure back of his throat, his blood becomes very thick like a syrup, he says. And that particular syrup flowed, he says. By comparison, tiger, nothing pushed aside all thoughts of Richard Parker. So, he says there is a comparison. When comparing to this pain, what pain? Not drinking water and having a lot of pain with the thirst is nothing compared to Richard Parker, he says. And fearless went exploring for fresh water. Now, Pi is not afraid of Richard Parker. Before, in the previous, we saw that he is very much afraid of Richard Parker because it was waving 450 pound, very big. Okay, so it was the very dangerous animal to be killed by Richard Parker, isn't it? So here, now Pi is not having any fear because he is suffering more than Richard Parker's thoughts. What is thoughts? That he will be killed by Richard Parker. That particular fear went away. Okay. Now he is worrying about water. So he decided now, let us not worry about Richard Parker, that Bengal tiger. Let us explore the fresh water. Why he says explore the water? Can we get fresh water or drinking water in the sea? You cannot get. But he says exploring, there is a reason for that, he says. Next, the divining rod in my mind. So, divining rod means the God given striking force. The God striking force in my mind told me, I remembered. Okay, that particular divining rod, the God's power made me to remember a genuine regulation lifeboat. What is this regulation lifeboat? You see, you might have seen the movie Titanic. In the Titanic movie, after the ship was broken into two pieces and it sank into the sea, okay, many people died. So, there were some 12 lifeboats were there, okay, only 12 lifeboats. So, in the ship, they had a lifeboat. What will be there in the lifeboat? There will be necessary things will be there in the lifeboat. What are they? Food and water, okay. So, some essential things will be there to be alive in the sea. So, that's what he says, a regulation of lifeboat. So, when a lifeboat is there should be a necessary thing should be there. So, he remembered the divining rod, the God's insight made him to remember, if there is a lifeboat, surely there will be water, he remembered. That's what he says. Such a lifeboat surely outfitted supplies. So such a lifeboat should must have with the supplies. What is the supply mean? Supply means water and food and necessary thing, he says. So his mind striked out and he was searching for fresh water. Now he asks, what captain failed so elementary a way ensure the safety of his crew? Then he gets another idea. A captain, a true captain, must ensure the safety of crew. Crew means what? The passengers, the workers. Okay. So he, the captain, must ensure the safety of his crew. So which means he must have a lifeboat. If there is a lifeboat, there must be what? Water and other necessary things should be there, he thought. Next, he asked himself another question. What ship Chandler? Who is a Chandler? Okay. Chandler means dealer, a ship dealer. What ship dealer will do? Not thinking of making a little extra money, noble guys of saving life. What do you mean by guys? Guys mean pretendants. See, usually this ship Chandler, who are these? The ship dealer will have a deals between the captains and the ship company, everything. Okay. When they build the ship, okay, they will have some kind of a contract. Okay. What are the contract? What are the things should be there and what are the rooms should be available and where should be the lifeboat and what are the things should be there in the lifeboat? So all the things will be decided by this ship Chandler and the company. Okay. So now he says this ship Chandler surely will not undo, or they will not do things which are against the passengers. Which means, for example, in order to save money, they may compromise the safety of the passengers, especially by what? Not keeping water, not keeping food, or not having a proper, very quality lifeboat. So these are the things they may compromise. But what he says, will the ship Chandler will compromise this? Okay. For not saving the noble. Who are the noble here? The passengers, those who are traveling. So what is his point is that the Chandler will be very truthful to himself, that he will have all the dealings which are favored to the people, those who travel in the ship. So they will not make more money risking the passengers' life, he says. So he says, okay, now settled. What is settled? The amount has been dealt with, and the ship Chandler, they have got the money. Now everything is over, he says. Then he decides. Then if the Chandler is very truthful, okay, very honest, then water aboard, which means there is water on the boat, he says. Okay, I made the middle of the boat. So what he says, surely there will be water if the ship Chandler is very honest. Okay, if he is very honest, surely there will be fresh water on the board, and I must find it, he says. Next he says, I made, what is this I made? Okay, I made it to the middle of the board. I was searching everywhere for the fresh water, and I was in the middle of the boat almost, he says. The edge of the tarpaulin. So already we have seen what is this tarpaulin. Okay, very hard sheet. Okay, so he was in the edge of the tarpaulin, he says, and he was crawling here and there, and he was searching for water, and he is almost in the middle of the boat and edge of the tarpaulin. Now what is the process is going on? The process is going on to find fresh water. Now Pi is no more afraid of whom? The Richard Parker, the Bengal tiger. He is not afraid of Bengal tiger. Now he needs water, only water. He wants to drink and live for many days. So he was searching, and the divine rod strike him and made him to remember, if the captain and the ship Chandler are very honest, there must be water in this lifeboat, so I must find it, he says. And you are searching. By the time he came in the middle of the boat and edge of the tarpaulin. So what we did, we discuss in this, the thirst, the comparison. Okay, the comparison of, yeah, he is giving more comparison, like a tennis player match. Okay, so comparing Pi and Richard Parker. And another example he gives, Jesus Christ died of thirst. Okay, and even if God died of thirst, what can an ordinary man can do? So I am an ordinary man, so how can I, what can I do if the God died thirst? Okay, died of thirst. So his mouth became putrid and pasty feelings, and he had a physical pains, everything. So his back of his throat was so pressurable, and he had his blood ran like a thick syrup. And he is no more afraid of Richard Parker, but he wants the wants to find the water in the lifeboat, and he wants to stay. Okay, that's all.